So here we are, guys, as we go into the final of this week's UQIC qualifier for the WCS. To go to London is Inf Blader and Lau. And Lau is playing Prolast, probably just because this is for seeding, it's not so important. And as we jump into this game, in the bottom, or in the on the left-hand side, spawning as the Red Terran. He just qualified to go to London. He's super excited. It is Inf Blader. And then on the right, spawning at the 3 o'clock position, normally playing Terran. He's playing Prolast now just for some fun. It is Lau. And of course, if many people don't know Lau, he's been around for quite a while. I believe he played Warcraft 3 at a high level. He joined Infused quite a while back. He did recently leave them. But he is badass. When he gets to play, he's badass. And he's a smart guy as well. I believe last year he finished his master's degree in business science. And he's also from Hong Kong, I believe. He's cool as hell, actually, Lau is. He's a good laugh. And, okay, so yeah, I don't know how good Lau's Protoss is. I don't know if he's trolling. I don't know what the hell is going on. But, yeah, man. This is exciting stuff. I bet he is so relieved and excited. Because I'm pretty sure this is the first one he's played in. He might play in another one. But, only for kicks. Because I don't think... Excuse me? No, actually, I don't think he played in any of the others. And we have... Yeah, I don't know what to expect, really. Blader should... really realistically win the series, and I feel quite proud. Like, you guys, you know, he just beat a GM, this Blader guy, and I beat Blader once. I took a game off him myself in the ESL finals of one of the weekly tournaments that they do for the United Kingdom. Second pylon down for Blin. So I'd imagine Blader will just be doing the same builds that we saw against Warchief. And Warchief must be very disappointed with his play there. He didn't well, but a bit greedy, a bit stale, I would say. He still played great, but it must be very disappointing to be that close to getting into the finals and obviously to the qualifier and then just bombing out like that. But Blader, in my opinion, is definitely the best person who deserves it over Warchief. And up until like I-45, I didn't know who Warchief is, and he's a GM. So like, I don't know. I'm sure he's cool and everything. I don't socialize with him. I've never spoke to him. So I guess it's just a bit of biasism. But like, Blader's been part of the UK scene for quite a while, man. For quite a while. So we have 3 racks, yep, 2 in production after the command center from Lau. We have a 1 racks expand, one gate expand, and he went Stalker first. He didn't get his Zalot, did he? No, he didn't. So he went for a little funky build. Stalker is out. What's he going to go after? Sentry? No. What the hell are you doing, Lau? You need an extra gas or some stuff. You can't just run around with one Stalker. I wonder what... If anyone knows what level Lau's Protoss is, please let me know. 3rd gateway. Ooh, Warreach. Warreach. Blader, that's very cheeky. Like I was talking about earlier with bunker placement, this is a nice spot, but it's a bit too far forward in my opinion. Just because like you can get nice force fields off, boom, really freaking easy. Whereas if they're, you know, force field, if this is by here, even though it's still the same range to get the force fields, you can't, it'd be like from there. Whereas that's just there, that's there. So it's more force fields. We have 3 gate Robo now from Lau, and not bad. He went gateways into Robo. Pylon over here, which is awesome. I love this. You always, as a pro, just build pylons everywhere against a Terran. So much fun. And you see everything. We have Stim. So yeah. Blader is definitely liking this build, I must say. We have 46 feet. Let's play. And strange. What is he doing? He's going for just he's gonna get speed. Charge lots. That's pretty much what looks like. He's forgot his main gas, what the hell? Yeah, he's going for speed. Charge lots. And he's just got the robo for lots of ops to fly around and see what's going on. Which is something I also agree with as well. We're just waiting for some extra... Nope, he's got enough gas. There it is. There you are, speed. Charge, whatever. Starboard now in production. Has he only built one observer? Aww. Why would he only build one observer? One forge being thrown down, which is cool. One's okay, one's fine. And then maybe when you hit like 1, 2, whatever, you can throw down the extra one then. But of course, this scan does go off and does see everything in production. He sees that. Of course, he doesn't know if it's blink or charge. Especially after the last games against Warchief, he may not know. And he gets weapons. Is that okay? We have an extra obs now. We have two observers on the map. A bit late, really. Should have had them a lot sooner. After this, I'm gonna be like, wow, I'm tired. Just forget everyone for me. Okay. And here we have a third CC thrown down now for Inf Blader. And it looks like he wants to do some pressure. Of course, this isn't all in. He can straight up win the game here. If something goes wrong, he can straight up lose the game here. If something goes wrong. But this is just a pressure build because, of course, he does have a third. And of course Lau has a third, so here we are, this is what he wants to do. He just wants to shut this down, which he will. Please. Oh, what the hell? He's just seen the pylon as it got thrown down. Some nice force fields there by Lau, but this is a little dangerous. It's just pure zealot sentry. Pick up your units, yeah. Pick up the units. And Lau's about to lose. No way is this gonna kill that. Not even a little bit. These marines are like, oh my god, stop tickling me, oh my god. So funny. Yep, Stim. That was doing it. You cheeky bugger.